Hello friends, welcome to the fourth microbiology lecture. And in this lecture, we want to talk about bacterial size and shape and arrangements. Because the bacteria are found in earth in different size, shapes and arrangements, like round or spherical or, you know, all round stick together. So we're going to talk about all these different things and what they mean and why they are present in different sizes and shapes. So stay tuned and watch this video. Now let's talk a little bit about all the bacterial shapes, sizes and arrangements that are available. Bacteria are present with so many varieties that we can see them in based on their shapes, arrangements and sizes, and we also call them differently based on these properties. So let me take a color first. Okay, so generally based on the shape of bacteria, it can be either spherical, we call it coccus, or it can be rod shaped, we can call them bacillus. Okay, and there are some other examples where we have coccobacillus, very short and plumpy shaped things. That means, you know, it's neither a full round shape nor a complete rod shaped, it's somewhere in the middle, so we call them the clumpy or very short clumpy shape. Then there are vibrio, which is a kind of curved in terms of bacillus. So it's actually a type of bacillus which is little bit curved. So normally let's assume that if this is the bacillus shape, then vibrio will be something like this, or bend something like this. While a coccobacillus is also a bacillus but little roundish, while a spherical or coccus is totally fully round shaped. Okay, so this is regarding the most common two different shape. Apart from that, there is another shape, spiral shape, helical shape. We call them spirillum. Either it can be of helical shape or comma shaped. It means comma means this, this kind of shape you have. Okay, twisted rod shape. Okay, spherical, like something like this. Okay, spirochete, for example. They are spring-like structures, as I mentioned. This spring-like structure. Okay, so these are the different shapes of bacteria that are available. So bacterial shapes and arrangements provide them with different names. Okay, so we can call them coccus or bacillus, and then depending upon how many of them stay together, put together, are termed as diplococcus, like triplococcus, things like that. So this is single coccus or single round or spherical shaped bacteria. When all of them stick together, let's say two of them stick together, so we call them pair of cocci, we call them diplococci. Okay, coccus is when single bacteria is there, and when plural of it is known as cocci, not coccuses, remember, cocci. And there are coffee bean shaped cocci also in pair, known as Neisseria, particularly Neisseria type. Okay, Neisseria is a type of gram negative cocci, which is very, very rare. Generally, cocci are gram positive, streptococci, staphylococci, but Neisseria species like Neisseria gonorrhoeae, they are gram negative cocci, very, very rare. So keep it in mind. Apart from there, we have tetrads, where four cocci stick together, packet of four. Then there are sarcini, where we have 8, 16, 32 cells in a packet, forming lattice-like structures, okay, cuboid structures. These are unique. We have streptococci, where multiple cocci link together like a chain, streptococci. And then we have staphylococci or micrococci. Staphylococci is when many spherical coccus stick together like you know, bunch of grapes. That is staphylococcus. Strepto is when there is a single cocci chain, that is strepto, and when it's in stacked, then it's known as staphylo. Apart from that, the rod shaped one, bacillus, and the plural, bacilli. So sometimes you can see that this bacilli also have a mix and match. The structure which is not exactly like the rod shaped, but little bit in between of rod and as well as coccus shaped, we call them coccobacilli, this one. And there are this vibrios, which are, you can see the rod shaped structures but little bent, curved rods. Example, Vibrio cholerae. And there are other spiral forms like spirochetes, like, you know, spring or wrapped spires, corkscrew type structures. Spirilia, spirilla, spirochetes, all these structures you can see like spring, like curved structures out there. And there are mycobacteria, are a very rope-like structure, thin. And spore-forming rods look something like this. It looks something like a lollipop, as you can see. This one, spore-forming rods. Because the rods, while forming the spore, the four spores start building in one particular pole. And as they start building the fourth spore, that part becoming thick due to the spore. So it looks like a lollipop-like structure, right? So that's a spore-forming rod. And then we have Corynebacterium. Corynebacteria, singular. Corynebacterium, plural. Similarly, bacteria, singular. Bacterium, plural. So Corynebacterium, they are palisades arrangement. Means palisade means the arrangement of the this rod-shaped structures stacking to one another sideways. That is a palisade structure that is formed. Okay. And there are other structures like streptomycetes, which is mold-like farmentous bacteria. Streptomycetes. So it's something like the mold. How the mold looks like. You know, if you look at mold under a microscope, you will also always see like a net and a mesh and a network of like a fiber network like structures that are around, and very thin and very visible, transparent structures you can see. That is streptomycetes, and that's what you can see in this case of bacteria. But these are streptomycetes, which is a bacterial type, not the mold, not the fungi, but it fungi like. Okay. So these are the very common shape and arrangement of bacteria, and based on these shapes and arrangement we call them differently. As I said, diplococci, like Neisseria is a unique feature. I mentioned streptococci, staphylococci, vibrio, spirilla, spirochetes, corynebacteria, mycobacteria, okay, streptomycetes. So you know about all in this one particular table. Now the pleomorphism that is present, that means the variation in cell shape size within a single species, often occurs in response to the environment. And that becomes very difficult for us to even think about which bacteria we are actually working with. As a researcher in the lab, we know that if we can see a bacteria under a microscope, we can see it to be a rod shaped or a round shaped. So we can look at it and we can clearly tell that yes, this is rod shaped, so this is a round shape. But sometimes they also change their structure. From the rod shaped structure, they modified it a little bit. They modified it a little bit and converts to something else. Means, you know, normal rod shaped structures, something like this. But instead of forming structures like this, they form little modified versions, for example, like this. Or they altered the structure something like this, like a coccobacilli. So if we check them under the microscope, let's say due to a heavy metal stress or osmotic stress, they alter this structure. They sometimes increase or decrease their surface area, and that becomes really difficult for us to identify them, because when we see it, we say that it's a coccobacilli, but in reality it's a bacillus only. Some species are noted for their pleomorphism. This pleomorphism is this effect of altering its shape and size based on the environmental conditions they are placed in. Okay, and it's common to many bacteria which generally are present in soil and in our common environmental conditions, not those which are generally infecting us and generally present in our tissue. Okay, but those which are generally present in the environment normally. So arrangement of cells dependent on pattern of division and how cells remain attached after the cell division. This is what dictates the pattern. That means how exactly the cell is divided, and even after the cell division, where the divided cells are present, whether they are separated from one another or they are stick to one another, where they stick to one another like a straight chain, or stick to one another like a grape, right? So cocci, as I said, single coccus. Okay, diplococci is in pair, so two coccus together is a pair. tetrad where four coccus are present. Irregular clusters are there. Cluster staphylococcus, chain streptococcus. Okay. And there are these cubical packets, or which is known as sarcina, are there. On the other hand, in the bacilli, diplobacilli means two bacilli connected to one another side by side. It can be a bacillus chain like this, okay, and it can be palisades. Palisades mean where these bacilli are connected side by side instead of head to head. So bacilli can be connected by head to head interaction. It's the very common arrangement of bacillus. Or the bacillus can be connected to one another side to side. So if it's connected side to side, then it is palisades. But if it's connected head to head, then it is a chain. Okay. So let's sum it up. So that's all about the bacterial size, shape and arrangements. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to our channel to get more and more videos like that. Thank you.